It's my snack time before class, and I have two more things to introduce you today. I couldn't decide on what to introduce next because there's so much stuff and it all looked so good. And I guess I was really hungry because, yeah, everything looked good and exciting and fun to introduce. But I decided that I'd introduce one of my favorite snacks as of now, and another very traditional snack or dessert. I guess they're both sort of desserts, or tea snacks for tea. In Japan, don't really have dessert. They don't have a tradition of eating dessert after dinner. So a lot of their sweet foods are made to eat with tea, maybe in the afternoon, you know, about 3 o'clock or so, snack time. But anyway, so they all taste really good with green tea. And some of them, these ones, I think, really taste good with coffee as well. First one, I'm gonna pick this one first. First one is called Azuki Monaka. And this is from 7-Eleven as well, because I have a 7-Eleven near my classroom and I always get my snacks there. But the Monaka is a very, very traditional Japanese snack. It has a very light cracker, and inside the cracker are various things, but the most traditional of all is bean paste, sweet bean paste. A lot of foreigners, when they come to Japan, mistaken bean paste with chocolate because it has the same kind of color. And they're so disappointed in it, they hate it because it just doesn't taste the way they think it should. But I'm thinking that if they knew that it was beans before they had tasted it, it might have turned out a little bit differently. So I urge anybody who has a chance to try the sweet bean paste. It's used for many, many snacks in Japan, and it's great with coffee. And I like it especially just because it gives me protein and a lot of fiber. So, anyway, so I'm going to open this up and I'll show you what's inside. Okay. I'm stuck here. Okay, so that's what it looks like. A very, very light biscuit. It's not even a biscuit. What should I? Very, very light, puffy kind of thing. Just kind of like the ofu, except it's not made from the same thing, I don't think. It's made from rice. The cracker's made from rice. So, definitely different from. But it's very, very light, just the same way. And it sticks to the roof of your mouth a little bit. But that's why you need kind of the inside. The inside looks like this. I'll open it up. And ta-da! The sticky bean paste inside there. And the beans, what they do is they get these red beans, little red beans, and they boil it until it's very soft. And put lots of sugar in, and then boil it again until it's pasty. And this stuff, the stuff that I like, actually has little bits of azuki, the bean, in it. Kind of like the difference between crunchy peanut butter and smooth peanut butter. They also have bitsy azuki and smooth azuki. This is the bitsy stuff, and it's yummy. So, I'm going to try one. Yeah, definitely sticks to the roof of your mouth. You have to kind of eat it carefully. But it's nice and sweet. Not as sweet as chocolate. Very kind of healthy tasting. And yeah, good, really good. They also have Monaka as ice cream. At the store, I was gonna buy actually a few Monakas as well, but I decided I was spending way too much money on this. There is Monaka with white ice cream and chocolate, which is very good as well. And the Monaka is made especially so that it'll crackle. I'll show it to you sometime. And there's also red bean ice cream inside the cracker for a Monaka ice as well. So Monaka is very, very much used as a snack in Japan and eaten a lot in various forms. So that's one. Oh man, that was actually really, really good. I haven't had that in a long time. Okay, and this is even better. The name is called the dorayaki. I don't know exactly why it's called dorayaki. But we have a show in Japan called Doraemon. And it's this blue robot that helps this little boy by taking all kinds of neat little things out of his pocket. And this Doraemon loves dorayaki. So it's very much a part of the kids' tradition as well. This is called Nama Dorayaki. I think it's because there is some whipped cream inside. And it has whipped cream and the bean paste, which is the very traditional dorayaki. So we have bean paste inside. And on the outside, it's kind of like a little pancake. It tastes a little bit differently. I think they use a lot more soda rather than baking powder in the pancake. So it has that interesting taste to it. There it is. Doesn't that look good? It's not chocolate. It's bean paste. But it's, oh man, it's to die for. So, soft pancake, not really soft, but you know, a nice soft pancake, and then we have some whipped cream and a blob of bean paste. This is my favorite snack. いただきます。 Soft. And each part of the little sandwich has its distinct taste. The pancake itself has the distinct taste, as I mentioned. And then you can taste the whipping cream and the harder bean paste for a nice combination. There you are. Dorayaki. See you later.